ChiliWaldorf.com. I've got Clint Baby here. And Clint, I have a question for you.
What's that?
Could you tell me anything about the law of attraction?
Law of attraction?
Yeah, like, you know, if I say I want to make $1 million, and I think about making $1 million all the time, will I make $1 million? Or if I think that I'm mad at somebody, and I'm mad, and that attracts madness, so everything gets mad.
I think
the law of attraction. They say there's a law of attraction.
I think there's a law of attraction, but the problem is that the law of attraction, we don't consider that other people are functioning under that same law of attraction.
Okay.
Because,
yeah, this is true.
Yeah, because say you want $1 million, right?
Uh-huh, yeah.
And this guy over here wants $1 million.
$1 million.
And these people put that intention out there.
Right.
There's going to be a clash. So it's like the clash isn't really even considered. It's just like, so what actually happens, I think, in the law of attraction, unfortunately, although it's a very good idea, I mean, and we need to be positive and we need to just kind of look at the bright side of stuff,
mm-hmm,
I think
yeah.
a lot of yeah. times it becomes a matter of the ego. And the people who succeed at mm-hmm. the law of attraction are mm-hmm. those people who can impress their egotistical demands on other people. And it becomes oppressive and exploitive. And that's unfortunate. I'm not saying that's across the board, but I've seen that too often times than not. And that's why I'm very hesitant when people start mentioning the law of attraction. Even though I like being positive, I believe in it, and I believe we need to look at the bright side.
Mm-hmm.
The other part of it is that there doesn't seem to be a consideration of obstacles can get in our way. I think some of the beauty of life is that it's about obstacles. I mean, and I think it's just a mentality, because if we think about it, it's just like, if life was really easy, it's like, I tried to watch hockey one time. I don't know if you watch much hockey. Are you
kidding me? My kid was in hockey.
and I went to a game, and I was
fun to watch.
I was bored.
Oh, you're bored. If you understand the game, though, Clint, it's fun to watch.
No, it wasn't. It wouldn't be.
If your child's in the game, it's fun to watch.
Maybe that might be.
Yeah, okay.
But the problem was I'm like, these guys need some ramps or something. Because it's just like, the only excitement I found was when they started beating up each other. And
okay.
it's like, and then I thought about, like, that's not really a good thing. That's not really a good thing to be excited about. But it's just like, but the whole thing is, what I'm thinking is, it's like a track is better when you have obstacles. And life has a sense of accomplishment when we have obstacles to overcome. So, and the law of attraction doesn't seem to account for those obstacles and say, or welcome them. It's just like, no, I should not have any obstacles. I should be able to get this. And I reach out and you're like, what happens to all those people that will fall on their face and fall on their face continuously? Did they just not believe enough? Did they not have enough good intentions?
Abraham Lincoln, he failed how many times before he became president?
I don't know how many
several.
Times he failed.
I don't know.
Did
six,
he?
Seven?
Seven?
He, yeah,
seven.
Several.
Seven.
Several. Yeah, a lot.
Okay.
He didn't.
Can't mess with Lincoln. It's my look right now.
But it's like law of attraction. Well, yeah. it's what you focus on and what you think you're supposed to be. And then it happens, doesn't it?
No. I mean, because other people are focusing on different things, and their fields of understanding and influence are always coming into your world. This is what you're dealing with in your world. You'd like this, but so many other people want something different. So how mm-hmm. do we, it's really how do we integrate our wants, desires, and intentions into other people's desires, wants, and intentions? And if we let our ego be thinner and mm-hmm. kind of put those rights aside, and not necessarily be exploited or be open to be exploited, but work with other people and learn to compromise and really learn to adjust and work within other people's intentions, that I think we have a true spirit of community. And this is what, you know, they have in some tribal cultures that we don't have in our modern civilized cultures.
Right.
That we're so drastically missing is because we're getting some success because we're learning that we have to be positive, we have to be hopeful,
right.
we want to look on the bright side, but we're not integrating it with other people's wants, desires, and intentions, and so it becomes egotistical and oppressive.
It becomes self-centered.
Yes.
Becomes self-centered, and I totally agree. They become self-centered, and they're all on their own, and the so-called cream is on the crop is a bunch of BS.
Well, and it's sad.
It is sad.
And it's sad because it's like, not just because it becomes oppressive, but it's not just oppressive for people who come in contact with them. It's oppressive for yourself. Because when it's all about you and your intentions and your dreams and your desires and your intentions, mm-hmm. you don't give room for other people to grab onto your dream. And it's about togetherness, it's about community, and it's about coming together. And because that's one of those obstacles to us of really accomplishing real worthwhile things in our life that are going to be a legacy to our children and our grandchildren. What ends up happening with a lot of those people is they become alone. And people get tired of that. And some people, if they are managed to be successful, they'll follow them for the money. When the money's gone, they're no longer around. And what happened to your intentions? Okay, so you got to all these things. Yeah. There's a good story I saw one time in one of the X-Files. And Scully and Mulder were going to this revival. Uh-huh. And there's this guy. They're like, well, what do you think about these healings? Scully said to Mulder. And he goes, oh, I don't know. It's, blah, blah, blah. So anyway, at the end of the episode, they find out the guy who's been committing all these murders is a guy that didn't want to be raised from the dead in the first place.
Raised from the dead in the
first
place?
He was raised from the dead, but he was killing all these people because he wanted to be left alone to die. And I think that's part of the whole thing of this laws of attraction. It's just like, you know what? When we get what we want, when we get what we think we need and we desire, will it really be all that we want, need, and desire? If we're the only ones that have it and we don't get to share it,
There's no fun. More the merry, it's no fun.
Exactly.
And you're sitting there with a pile of money, and what are you going to do with it, right?
What are you going to do with it?
Exactly. Just, I see it. I see exactly what you're talking about. But, I guess people who are stronger and more focused, they have that happen, and they sit there alone, or they hang out with the other people that have their piles of money, and they're all ego, and if someone gets hurt, do they help each other? You don't know. Because it wasn't tribal in the first place. It was cliquish, but it wasn't tribal.
Exactly.
Cliquish and tribal are two different things.
Right.
And that's the conclusion I've come up with too. Interesting. Well, Clint.
Yes.
Thank you, my dear. You're always full of good knowledge, you know.
I try.
Food for thought. Okay. Julia Waldorf, juliawaldorf.com. Ciao, ciao.